Hey all, welcome to ShareTrek. I'm your host Raj. Today we are going to talk about a new drug against HIV. The name is BIT225 from Biotron of Australia. This comes at the request of one of our subscribers. I did not know about this therapy until he referred this to me. So that said, let's get started. Welcome back. BIT225 is developed by Biotron Limited, an Australian biotechnology company. Biotron Limited focuses on the discovery and development of novel antiviral therapeutics, and BIT225 is one of their experimental drug candidates. BIT225 works by blocking what is called as the ion channel activity of the viral protein VPU. By blocking VPU, ion channel activity, BIT225 disrupts the assembly of HIV within host monocyte cells. The method of action of BIT225 is unique among HIV drugs. It is the first drug to target VPU ion channel activity. It has effects on the monocyte-derived macrophages because BIT225 targets replication specifically in monocyte-derived macrophages, a type of immune cell. This characteristic offers promise for treating viral reservoirs that may not be affected by standard treatments. The activity of BIT225 occurs post-virus integration, meaning it affects the stages of the viral life cycle after the virus has integrated into the genetic material of its host cell genome. BIT225 does not have direct effects on the HIV enzymes reverse transcriptase and protease, which are common targets for other antiretroviral drugs. Since VPU ion channel activity is highly conserved, the virus is less likely to develop resistance through the generation of VPU ion-independent variants. Additionally, BIT225 has been credited with curing hepatitis C after 12 weeks of treatment, suggesting a broader antiviral efficacy. The viral protein U, or VPU, is a protein encoded by the human immunodeficiency virus type 1 and plays a crucial role in the life cycle of the virus. The VPU ion channel activity is a specific function of this protein that has implications for the progression of HIV infection. The VPU protein encoded by HIV-1 plays a crucial role in the virus's pathogenicity. It has been associated with multiple functions, including the degradation of CD4 and the inactivation of BST2, both of which are important for viral release and immune evasion. Additionally, VPU has been found to possess ion channel activity, which can impact the transport of potassium and the depolarization of plasma membranes, leading to the enhanced viral release and cellular secretions. Furthermore, VPU interacts with TASK1 proteins, that is TASK1, TASK1 proteins, inhibiting their ion channel activity. This multifaceted role of VPU contributes to the pathogenesis of HIV-1 infection and its ability to evade the host immune system. The ion channel activity of VPU is particularly significant as it has been linked to the efficient release of HIV virions. Despite its small size, VPU has been shown to possess cation, which is positive ion channel activity, which can be inhibited by specific blockers. In summary, the VPU protein of HIV-1 is a multifunctional protein that contributes to the virus's pathogenicity through various mechanisms, including ion channel activity, CD4 degradation, and immune evasion. Its diverse functions make it a crucial target for understanding and potentially disrupting the viral life cycle. Now let us visit the Biotron website to see what they have to say about their clinical trial results. It says here that BIT225 is a novel first-in-class HIV VPU protein inhibitor with the aim of inhibiting virus replication in cellular reservoirs. So they are targeting reservoirs while the ART is going to work on the active viruses. In vitro studies have shown BIT225 does the whole set of things. So in vitro is always preclinical. So here we are talking about preclinical results. So it has shown that it significantly inhibits HIV-1 release in a dose-dependent manner from CD14+ and CD16+ monocyte subsets at various stages of differentiation and monocyte-derived dendritic cells, MDDC. Significantly reduces cell-to-cell transmission of virus from HIV-1 infected myeloid lineage cells to CD4+ T cells, and has broad spectrum activity against clinical isolates from different virus clades and selected drug-resistant strains, and has additive or synergistic inhibition of virus replication in combination with marketed HIV antiretroviral drugs from different classes. So it can go along with a ART to provide additional support, especially for, I think, people who have got multiple drug resistance. I think that this would perform extremely well in reducing the viral load. Then we are talking about clinical trial results. Studies in the clinic have demonstrated the following. So these are all demonstrated in humans. So BIT225 treated isolated cells from HIV-1 infected patients show reduced HIV-1 release from CD14 plus monocytes. So because the VPU is degraded, the output of HIV virions from those CD14 plus monocytes was reduced significantly. Following 10 days of monotherapy in HIV-1 infected patients, BIT225 can reduce viral copy numbers and inhibit replication in myeloid lineage cells, including dendritic cells. So after 10 days of this therapy, there was significant reduction in viral copy numbers. And then we say BIT225 may impact on macrophage-associated immune activation, and BIT225 is able to cross the blood-brain barrier with potential to treat HIV-related neurocognitive disorder or HAND. This is an additional benefit of BIT225. So to me, it seems like a powerful drug which can potentially get sterilizing cure closer to fruition. Of course, it has got more positive effect on hepatitis C virus as well, but that's not in the scope of our coverage. So in summary, I would say that the ion channel activity of the VPU is associated with facilitating the efficient release of assembled virions from the host cell membrane. This activity is particularly relevant in certain cell types such as macrophages, where VPU's functions are critical for overcoming cellular restrictions and ensuring the successful spread of the virus. And the inhibition of VPU's ion channel function as targeted by BIT225 disrupts this late-stage assembly process and may hinder the release of virions, potentially impacting the virus's ability to infect new host cells. And we saw exactly this was demonstrated in the clinical trials. So friends, that's all for now. I would like to hear from you. Put your comments so that I can read them and understand what you're thinking about this. And a very thanks to the subscriber who brought this therapy to my notice. And we have this video for you guys. I'll be back with the next video very soon. Thanks for watching. If you're not yet subscribed, please subscribe. If you already subscribed, please press the notify button so that you do not miss the next video. I bring out 2 videos every week, and it has got subtitles in almost 10 to 12 different languages. Just check the subtitle to see the language of your choice so that you can enjoy this video in your own language. Thanks and have a great day. Bye for now.